Hello everyone! We noticed that a large number of you guys watch our videos without subscribing, so what's stopping you? Click here to stay updated with our latest nerdy content. And back to the video.
Assalamu alaikum everyone, welcome back to another ATP video. Today, we'll be talking about one of the tick-borne diseases which cause severe illnesses and death in many healthy adults and children. These diseases are caused by a clinically important bug known as rickettsia, and it's often tested in many exams. Let us start with a brief introduction about rickettsia. Rickettsia is an obligate intracellular bacterium, which is named after Howard Taylor Ricketts, who identified the Rocky Mountain spotted fever outbreak in Montana. Despite the similar name, rickettsia bacteria has nothing to do with rickets, which is a result of vitamin D deficiency. Now let us move on and talk about its important features. Rickettsia is a diverse collection of obligately intracellular gram-negative pleomorphic rods that are found in and transmitted by arthropod vectors like ticks, lice, fleas, mites, chiggers, and mammals. Its survival depends on entry, growth, and replication within the cytoplasm of eukaryotic host cells. Rickettsia species are known to cause two common diseases, including Rocky Mountain spotted fever and typhus. Now let us start by talking about Rocky Mountain spotted fever, which is caused by Rickettsia rickettsii. Rickettsia rickettsii is transmitted by bites of infected dog ticks. Rickettsia spreads via the bloodstream to infect the endothelium from the portal of entry in the skin, and sometimes they infect vascular smooth muscle cells, resulting in capillary leakage and vasculitis. Rickettsia species enter the target cells, multiply by binary fission in the cytosol, and damage heavily parasitized cells directly. During the initial stages of the disease, the patient could experience fever, nausea, vomiting, loss of appetite, conjunctival injection, which means red eyes, and a rash which typically starts at the wrists and ankles and then spreads to trunk, palms, and soles. Please remember that the rash in the palms and soles is a very characteristic rash seen only in Coxsackievirus A infection, which is known as hand, foot, and mouth disease, Rocky Mountain spotted fever, and secondary syphilis. Now regarding typhus, it's a disease caused by two Rickettsia species, Rickettsia proboscidei and Rickettsia typhi, and is characterized by a rash that starts centrally and spreads out, sparing the palms and soles. Rickettsia proboscidei is the etiologic agent of epidemic typhus, transmitted in the feces of lice. If the host has rickettsia circulating in the blood, and the lice attach to the human host several times daily to take a blood meal, then it will become infected with Rickettsia proboscidei. Rickettsia typhi is a flea-borne disease that is best known to be the causative agent for the disease Murine typhus, which is an endemic typhus in humans that is distributed worldwide. Murine typhus is an acute febrile illness that is mainly transmitted by the fleas of rodents. Humans acquire infection by inhalation or by self-inoculating infected fleas or flea defecating into skin when they visit disease-endemic areas infested with rats. Most patients present with a fever and many have a rash and headache, although it can also lead to disseminated multisystemic disease, including infections of the brain, lung, liver, kidney, and heart endothelium. How can we diagnose patients with rickettsia? Rickettsia does not gram stain well, as it's an obligate intracellular bacterium. Gimsa stain is the best way to visualize rickettsia. Early diagnosis is difficult because early signs and symptoms are usually nonspecific or mimic benign viral illnesses. However, there are certain features that aid in making the early diagnosis of rickettsial diseases, including a history of tick bite or exposure, recent travel to endemic areas, and similar illness in family members, co-workers, or family pets, especially dogs. In the lab, you can diagnose rickettsia using either nucleic acid amplification test to amplify and detect bacterial DNA, or by serology, including rapid diagnostic tests, indirect immunofluorescence assays, and ELISA. So after assessing a patient's signs and symptoms, clinical history, and laboratory test results, all of these can help guide decisions regarding the treatment of rickettsial disease. Doxycycline is the antibiotic of choice for adults and children. Chloramphenicol may be used as an alternative to doxycycline and is used instead of doxycycline as first line in pregnancy, However, this drug may cause side effects, and monitoring of blood indices may be needed. We've discussed everything about rickettsia. Now the question is, how can we prevent it? It can be prevented with wearing long-sleeve protective clothing and a broad-brimmed hat to reduce the risk of infection when undertaking activities where human contact with ticks, lice, mites, or fleas may occur. In addition to that, using an insect repellent and examining your skin for possible bites following these activities may be helpful. All right, to sum up, rickettsia is an obligately intracellular gram-negative pleomorphic rods bacteria. Rickettsia is transmitted via ticks. Rickettsia species can cause Rocky Mountain spotted fever, which is caused by Rickettsia rickettsii, and typhus is caused by Rickettsia typhi and Rickettsia prowazekii. Finally, rickettsia can be treated with doxycycline or chloramphenicol. And that's it for rickettsia. We hope you found it beneficial. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to receive our latest updates. And don't forget to follow us on Twitter. And that's about it. Thank you.